This is Fantastic Mr. Fox, a 2009 stop-motion animated film directed by Wes Anderson. It's a pretty widely loved film by audiences and critics, and it is my personal favorite film ever made. If you've been around my channel long enough, you'll know this, and maybe even know that I've actually made this video before. Twice. Both videos are deleted, so don't bother, but I feel like they didn't do my feelings toward this film justice, so I wanted to make a refined version. Fantastic Mr. Fox is an extremely unique animated film, unlike any that came out in the same year. On the surface, it seems like just a normal film about a fox who is bored with his daily monotonous life, and by spicing it up, he puts all his family and friends at risk. But truly, it is much more. While other animated films decide to be outlandish and crazy for the most part, Fantastic Mr. Fox serves as a film accessible to kids and adults that is very relatable and can teach good values. Today I'm going to be explaining the brilliance of this film and why it's been my favorite movie for over 10 years now. Fantastic Mr. Fox is a beautifully crafted film. Co-written by Noah Baumbach and Anderson himself, this was bound to be great. I think the collaborative effort between Baumbach and Anderson is an almost perfect combination. Baumbach brings incredible realism and emotion into his writing, and Anderson brings quirkiness and weird yet likable characters. Both write amazing dialogue, and it really shows in this film. The argument that the dialogue isn't good in this movie is a completely subjective issue. It has really great dialogue, but it has strong hints of Wes Andersonisms and really quirky and weird exchanges. If you're not used to this, it can be really jarring. But as someone alongside plenty of others who love the quirkiness, I really love the dialogue in this film, and it even has subtle comedic elements that are really low-key but actually add to the tone of the film.
You're supposed to be my lab partner.
I am.
No, you're not. You're disloyal.
Small little things like this seem pretty insignificant, but in reality it's small jokes like this that not only act as comedic relief, but add to the lightheartedness to the tone of the film, which is essential for how this film wants to come across. I could definitely talk about each individual character and how their arcs are perfectly written into the screenplay, but I will be touching on that slightly later. To wrap this section, I'll just say one thing.
Well, I guess he's just different.
Oh, what time is it? I'm sorry.
This is Kylie. He's the super. He's a little,
A wet sandwich. He's too short. He dresses like a girl. He's different.
Ash, I know what it's like to feel different.
I'm grumpy. I spit. I wake up on the wrong side of the bed. I'm just different, apparently.
So, obviously everyone will talk about the animation when they talk about Fantastic Mr. Fox. I am no different, because the stop motion animation and the different shots they used, specifically the tracking shots, would be so painstakingly tedious to do, but it 100% paid off. Every scene is seamlessly and beautifully animated, and there is so much attention to detail. The color grading is also amazing. The warm yellow and orange tones make for a very comforting experience, and something that perfectly encapsulates the film. Anderson is known for using colors often very boldly, and it makes for such an awesome world to be in, and one that you can't help but love. I adore the music in this film. It quite possibly is my favorite score and soundtrack in a movie ever. When someone mentions Fantastic Mr. Fox, there are a few songs that I think of.
Oh, but the scenic route is so much prettier.
Okay, let's take the scenic route.
Great. I've been in this town so long and back in the city. I've been taken for lost and gone and unknown for a long, long time.
Now you may ask, why'd you include the scenes if you remember the music? It's because the music is so memorable and amazing in this film that I remember the scenes that the music is in. If I ever listen to Heroes and Villain by the Beach Boys, I think of the long tracking shot of Mr. and Mrs. Fox doing some crazy parkour stuff through the squab farm. The soundtrack is perfect and fits completely with every scene and the overall tone that the film is conveying. Something that people might not realize is that there is an original score in here composed by Alexandre Desplat. It is so perfect and fits the fun, lighthearted tone of the film and is something that keeps me coming back to this film constantly. The characters in Fantastic Mr. Fox are the main driving factor in the central narrative. The whole story is about every main character who has some sort of existential or identity crisis. Mr. Fox's is
existentialism, you know?
Where if people don't see him as the quote-unquote Fantastic Mr. Fox, he doesn't feel good about himself. He holds himself to such a high standard and is not content with his life. He used to steal birds, which he claims is the one thing he was ever good at, but was forced to quit when him and his wife were almost killed doing it while she was pregnant with their first son, Ash. Because of this, he was forced into a job he wasn't good at and didn't enjoy. Throughout the film, we see him finally letting go. He knows he's going to die somewhat soon, so he selfishly decides to steal birds again, except this time from the three meanest farmers, Bogus, Bunsen, Bean. Eventually, as you probably know, it leads to putting everyone in danger. His wife gets angry at him, he feels regret, and delivers a powerful monologue to his son Ash about his regrets and how Ash was actually a great person. Or Fox, I guess.
Ash, I'm so glad he was you. It's not your fault. It's mine.
Throughout the movie, he is said to be scared of wolves. This is not to be taken literally, but rather a metaphor for his fear of losing or being normal. He's scared that he's just another fox, another animal passing by. But by the end, after countless failures, monologues, and revelations, Mr. Fox finally comes to terms with the fact that he is in fact just a wild animal in the Canis Lupus scene, which is the focal point of the whole film and the reason it was said to have been made. In the end, Mr. Fox doesn't lose, but he doesn't really win either. This choice was really mature for an animated film which is primarily marketed to kids, but I think it pays off tremendously. The other main arc, Ash, is a character who goes from being super annoying, egotistical, and weak, to turning around and being friendly, accepting, and athletic. A running joke throughout the movie was finally resolved and potentially my favorite scene of the whole film.
I weigh less than a slice of bread.
What?
I'll be right back. Ash!
Dodge the grabbers,
duck the taggers,
jump the twig basket, and knock the cedar stick off the cross rock.
Other characters don't have big arcs like Ash and Mr. Fox, but they all provide to the narrative in a way that supports the two main arcs while having fun and memorable characters in the mix.
Saw a flea, kick a tree, boopa woopa foopa woopa. Saw a flea, kick a tree, foopa woopa John.
There are plenty of themes to dissect in this film, and I think it presents these themes in a mature yet accessible way. However, there are two main ones that I think are the main focuses in this film: the importance of family and pride. As previously mentioned, Mr. Fox selfishly decided to do bird heists again, which put his family and friends in danger. He's scolded by his wife, Felicity, for doing this, and tells him that they're all likely to die because of him. It's in this moment that Mr. Fox finally realizes his wrongdoing, and ultimately decides he must sacrifice himself in order to keep everyone safe, since he put this all onto them. It's this that defines Mr. Fox's final character. He eventually comes to terms with his selfishness, and realizing the importance of his family, selflessly turns himself in, obviously before realizing that Christofferson was kidnapped, but regardless, the principle of it still stands. Pride being the other main theme of the film is represented through both main characters. Mr. Fox is extremely self-conscious and can't accept whenever he's not the quote-unquote Fantastic Mr. Fox, and that sense of pride is what leads to his eventual downfall. He let his pride get in the way, which led to the heists, which obviously led to the farmers putting all the animals in danger. In Ash's case, he wants to be accepted and be talented. This is represented with him always asking if he's an athlete when he really just wants acceptance and reassurance, which he eventually gets, thus closing his arc. And that is basically all for the video. If you enjoyed, please like the video, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell. If you want to see more video essays, please let me know because I have a few planned and will definitely make sure to get those videos done if you guys want to see them. But yeah, hopefully this video changed your mind on the film, reinforced your love for it, or even convinced you to watch it for the first time. Let me know if you've seen this film and what you think of it in the comments, but that's basically it from me guys, and I will see you in the next one.